An empty set is unique, which I already told you that if I have three empty sets, then they are always equal. They are always five. They are always equal, and they are always equal to this thing. Means there is only one empty set in the whole universe, which is a set with no elements. So I'm saying, to prove this, again, I will use the method of contradiction, and I will assume that, what should I do? I will assume that no, I know there exists some, there exist two sets, E1 and E2, which I am assuming they are empty, E2, and both are empty sets. But E1 is not equal to E2. They are not unique. They are not the same. I am saying there exist two empty sets which are different than each other. Then I have to, I'm assuming on the contradiction. Actual thing is that they are always equal. There is only one empty set in the universe which has no element. I'm saying no, there exist two sets which have, which are not equal, which are not not unique. Now I already proved the previous theorem, so I will use that theorem again here. Use that theorem here. So I am, from using the previous theorem, I said that if a set E is empty set, then it is a subset of every other set. I say that if I'm saying that E1 and E2 are empty, now forget about E2 for the moment and just pick up the E1, and I'm saying this is an empty set, then if E1 is an empty set, then this is a subset of every other set on the universe. So if it is a subset of every other set on the universe, then of course E2 is also existing on the universe. So it means this E1 is also a subset of this E2, which is any other set on the universe. This E1, I'm saying the empty set from here, and this two, I'm assuming any other set also, although it is empty, but it is also in any other set. This thing from the previous theorem. And I have got one equation. Now, again, for the moment, forget about the E1 and pick up E2 as empty set. Again, using the previous theorem, pick up E2 as empty set. And I'm saying that E2 is an empty set. Then by definition of empty set, E2 is a subset of any other set on the universe. If E2 is a subset of any other set on the universe, then of course, it will also be a subset of E1, because in this case, when I'm picking up E2, all other sets become any other sets. So this means E2 is also a subset of E1. This is equation 2. From 1 and 2, what does this mean? We told you that if A is a subset of B and B is a subset of A, what does this mean? It means A is equal to B. We know this. So using this, 1 and 2, they give me that E1 is a subset of E2 and E2 is a subset of E1. What does this mean using this concept? It means both are equal. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Disproving, yes, an alleged set property. To disprove any of the properties, say, which I gave you previously, that A union B, A intersection B is a subset of A. So if you want to disprove, you just need to find one single example, and that is known as the counterexample. You already know this from the previous chapter, that if you find some counterexample, then even if there are 20 pages used to prove a theorem, one line example is enough, which is called a counterexample, is enough to disprove your inequality. So you can also use this method in set theory, that if you find one single example that can be used as a counterexample, then you can disprove the set equalities. And final theorem, the things will finish here. And now, one final theorem for the set theory, and then we will talk about some properties of the Boolean algebra. That's it. So the theorem is that the P of A, the power set of any set, are always equal to 2 raised to the power n. show that the power sets of A, this is calligraphic P, not the simple P. So for the power sets, you use calligraphic P. The power sets of a set, any set A, is always equal to 2 raised to the power n. So first thing, and we are going to prove it. To prove this, since there is an n involvement, so we can use the mathematical induction. Using the mathematical induction, you already know that first you have to figure out what is your P of n. The P of n is that the power sets of A are 2 raised to the power n. This is your P of n. Means all the power sets of a set A are 2 raised to the power n. Now, what is the first step in mathematical induction? For n equals to 0, you prove P of 0. In this case, if you put P of 0, what will happen? What will be the P of 0 for this P of n? Okay, let me define this again for you.
Thank you.
A set A with n elements has 2 raised to the power n subsets. This is P of n. Now, convert this P of n into P of 0. Tell me, a set A with, for P of n there is n, for P of 0 no, are you here? What's wrong? So we know that P of n is a general expression when we are trying to prove something by using mathematical induction. And the first step is we try to prove it, to prove the P of 0. Now, for P of 0, I can convert this P of n that a set A with, if there was n, then I will use 0. A set A with 0 elements has 2 raised to the power, wherever there is n, replace it with 0, subset. What does this mean? It means that P of A, if A has 0 elements, is equal to 2 raised to the power 0, which is 1. And you also know that a set with 0 elements is equal to an empty set. And this is 5. And this is for this set, because this is a set, a subset of itself, there is only one subset, which is phi. So the thing is true here, that if a set has 0 elements, then it has one subset, and that is itself. By using the properties of the set with 0 elements, which is an empty set. So we have proved the P of 0. Now, and when we are done with the P of 0, then we are eligible to collect the gift. And what is the gift? The gift is that, gift is P of K. That is, a set with K elements has 2 raised to the power K subsets. Means that the P of A, when A has K elements, is equal to 2 raised to the power k. Now this is a gift, and we will use this one and this one to do something there. In general, the power set, I told you that when you increase one element, for example, for this set, the power sets of this set were 4. But if I increase one element in this set, and I say that x, y, and z, and I try to calculate the power sets of this set, you will see that the power sets of this set will be 8 in number. So Actually, when you increase one element in a set from 2 to 3, the number of power sets are increased two times. Two times the power sets of the previous set, and it becomes 8. So just keep this thing in mind, and we will also use this thing and this thing to prove that P of k plus 1. Now this is a gift, P of 0 we have proved, so we have to show P of k plus 1. And I'm saying that I have to show, now this thing we have to show, that P of k plus 1 is true. What does this mean? It means that a set with k plus 1 elements has 2 raised to the power k plus 1 subsets. So this thing we have to show. Now since k plus 1 is always greater than or equal to 1, this means we can and pick up any element from the set whose total number of elements are k plus 1. So if I'm saying that x is a set, where is the page? Yeah. If I say that x is the set with k plus 1 elements. Now, so if this x has total k plus 1 elements, and from these k plus 1 elements, if I pick up one element, let's say z is an element of this set x, and I pick up this element and I make a subset of it, z. Now one subset is out, one element of the x is out. If one element is out, then what is left in this k? It is actually x minus one element z. Now what is this thing? If you subtract one element from the k plus 1, then the rest of the elements are how much? Actual x has k plus 1 elements. I have subtracted one element from this whole k plus 1. Then what is the rest of the elements? I have subtracted any element z from these k plus 1 elements, then the rest of the thing, the rest of the set has k elements. And for the k elements, I have already the gift that if you have this kind of expression, then it has 2 raised to the power k subsets. If a set has k elements, then its subset number are 2 raised to the power k. So if it has 2 raised to the power k sets, then using this concept which I told you here, that when you increase one element in a set, if you increase one element in a set, the number of subsets increase two times. Now the actual, this thing was valid for x minus this element. Now if I add this element back into these total elements, then the total x will become two times into this thing, the subsets. Because of this concept, if it becomes two times into this thing, then k plus 1 is equal to k plus 2 raised to the power k plus 1, and this is the total quantity of the subsets of the set x, and I already assume that x is a set which has k plus 1 elements. This is the logic which you are trying to convince the audience by using a logical argument, and this all thing stuff you have learned from this course.